Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and children, too. My name is Dave Klein, executive producer for the show you're about to hear. I, along with many others from WEEU, will be your hosts throughout this Christmas Eve, Christmas morning, day, and evening with very special local radio programming from WEEU, the only locally owned and operated radio station that's commercial remaining in Berks County. In your home, in your car, at your place of business, while you're working, with family, friends, or by yourself, we invite you to share in the award-winning tradition we call WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound. The festive holiday recordings that you'll hear were made right in our home community of Reading and Berks County. Some of the recordings are vintage and date back many years, while others are brand new. I like to think of the recordings as Christmas tree ornaments. Each year, we carefully get them out of storage, make sure that they still sparkle with happy memories, and then present them to you. The recordings we'll share for your enjoyment this Christmas Eve and Christmas Day were made live at various concerts and community events, and other recordings were made right here in the WEEU radio studio or in our sound room studio at 34 North 4th Street in Reading. Still other recordings we made in recording studios or in nearby community studios. All of the recordings featured in our holiday offering to you are made by local musicians, singers, and entertainers. Perhaps you'll hear yourself, or a family member, or a friend, or co-worker. For sure, you'll hear our community, unified by song and the spirit of this joyous holiday season. Our broadcast will not be interrupted by commercials. Rather, for the sixth year in a row, the broadcast is brought to you by the nonprofit Reading Musical Foundation. So you'll hear two messages from the RMF per hour about the good work they do in Reading and Berks County, and we thank them for their continued support and for what they do in our community. So now, without further delay, thank you for listening to WEEU. May you and yours enjoy the blessings of a Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, and no matter what your faith, ethnicity, race, or heritage, please have a peaceful and happy holiday season and new year ahead. Here is our WEEU Holiday Festival of Sound.
We're going to enjoy lots of local talent during this WEEU Holiday Festival of Sound broadcast. Mike Faust here, and now it's time to present the Reading Symphony Youth Orchestra. Since 1989, the Reading Symphony Youth Orchestra has been serving the community as part of the mission of the Reading Symphony Orchestra. Hundreds of young musicians from the region have gained the experience of performing classical orchestral music of the highest caliber. Beyond central Pennsylvania, the Reading Symphony Youth Orchestra has traveled and performed in youth musical group festivals, Virginia Beach, Boston, and Toronto, Canada. The RSYO was honored to perform at the Pennsylvania Music Educators Association annual meeting in 2000 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. In June 2001, the RSYO embarked on their first trip abroad to the United Kingdom, performing four concerts in their 10-day tour. In 2003, the group toured French Canada. In 2004, they returned to Europe touring Germany, Austria, Switzerland, and Prague. And the orchestra had a successful tour to Italy in 2007. Now, here's the Reading Symphony Youth Orchestra.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Matt Gourney, and you're listening to WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound. Now here's the fabulous Ringgold Band with a festive rendition of the Parade of the Wooden Soldiers.
Ever see those handsome wooden furniture caliber console radios of old? Well, they're antiques now, relics of a time when a radio in the living room was equivalent to a TV there today. So what did a gorgeous, highly decorated, six-leg walnut cabinet, silver-tone brand radio cost at Sears, Roebuck & Company 75 years ago? Well, first, the stats. It had a 10-tube super heterodyne feature. It's a 1933 silver tone. Newest superpower tubes, double pentoed power output tubes, large 10-inch dynamic speaker, personal tone control, automatic volume control, full-size heavy-gauge steel chassis. And it was sold on easy terms, by the way. And it came complete with 10 factory-matched silver tone tubes delivered and installed at Sears. You wanted to go to Sears. You don't go where it is now. No, no, no. You went to 420 Penn Street in 1932. And you wanted to give them a call, you just dialed 5281. There it was. Somebody won't answer. Okay, what is the price of this silver-tone, gorgeous, beautiful, powerful radio? $39.95. You could also stretch your Christmas budget with an easy payment plan, $5 down, $5 monthly, in 1932.
This is WEEU's Dave Klein, and we're celebrating the holiday season by chatting with some of our friends and notable folks here in our own community. Next up on our WEEU Holiday Festival of Sound, Andrew Constantine, music director and conductor of the Reading Symphony Orchestra, chats with our own Mike Faust about some of the Christmas traditions of his native country of England. And he talks about some of the cultural differences and the differences in the traditions between our country and Great Britain.
Essentially, it's the same, of course, but there are a few details, I suppose, that are a little different. We have this tradition of something called Boxing Day, and I know you're getting your fist ready to beat me up there, I can tell. But it's not about fighting; it's not that sort of boxing. The idea was originally it was to do with the day when the servants got their boxes with gifts in from their employers. And so it's a tradition that's just passed on to everybody now. So effectively it's the day when people who haven't been able to see each other on Christmas Day, they make special trips to see each other on Boxing Day and eat up the previous day's leftovers and things like that. So there's a lot of turkey curry happens on Boxing Day.
So it's actually the day after Christmas, Boxing Day.
Yes, the 26th of December.
That is Andrew Constantine, who does admit he has at least one favorite holiday memory.
Well, there are two things. One great memory I have is when I got my first, I was going to say bicycle, but it wasn't. It was a tricycle. So I was that young. And what my parents used to do was they'd hide my presents under a big white sheet so that I'd go in, I'd see the bulge in this sheet and then go and pull it back and see what was there. And I can remember my blue tricycle, my lion tricycle it was. And I had years of fun out of that. Even when I'd grown out of it, I still used to love flying around on that thing. So that was good fun. And then another rather silly memory is shooting my sister in the forehead with a champagne cork one Christmas. That was a total accident. Everybody was sitting there at the dinner table and all ready for me to open the champagne. And there was great anticipation. And I hadn't chilled it properly. And the cork flew off at several hundred miles an hour and got a smack in the forehead. She did forgive me for it, but it took a while.
RSO conductor Andrew Constantine says that with his family here in Reading and his extended family still in England, observing standing traditions is especially important.
I try to keep it the same, but then that's something that my wife and I think it keeps our memories of Christmas going rather than just preserving the tradition. Maybe that's what preserving traditions is all about, keeping the memories from your own childhood. I can't think of anything specific. We have Christmas pudding. You have Christmas pudding here?
No. What's that all about? Like figgy pudding?
It's a stewed pudding, it's a fruit pudding, and you cook it and then you boil it for like 8 hours on the stove, and then you have it either with a white sauce or with custard, which is an English delicacy, of course, crème anglaise, as the French would call it, that's something we all look forward to as well. Though we have to have it later and later in the day now because, you know, you look at it and think, I'm a little full at the moment, I can't go for that just yet. Brussels sprouts as well. Christmas means Brussels sprouts to us.
I like Brussels sprouts, yeah.
Do you?
Oh, yeah.
One of the few Americans I know who likes Brussels sprouts.
You got it. Well, those are great memories.
Yeah. I bet you don't have Yorkshire pudding, though, do you?
No. I've heard of it.
Okay.
Well, but I don't think I've ever had it. What does it taste like?
It's heaven.
Like Yorkshire pudding?
It tastes just like Yorkshire pudding, especially the way my mum makes it. I'm looking forward to her making it for us this Christmas. And my kids, they love it as well, and they're desperate to get back to have them decently made because I keep making them, and they're a feeble reflection of what they're used to. And we don't call them Yorkshire puddings in our household. When my son was growing up and he was very small, he couldn't say Yorkshire, but he heard the word orchestra a lot. So he called them orchestra puddings, and it was as close as he could get to Yorkshire.
Classical or nylon string guitars have the perfect voice to produce the musical flavor for many of our most beloved holiday carols. Hello, I'm WEEU's Mike Faust. And now, as we continue our holiday festival of sound, here's one of the region's most versatile guitarists, Dave Cullen, with a deliciously tasty performance of The Little Drummer Boy.
Thank you.
You're listening to WEEU Radio, 830 on the AM dial, Reading, Pennsylvania. Merry Christmas and happy holidays to you. This is WEEU's copywriter, Paul Drusba. We just heard Berks County's own Dave Cullen. And now, as we continue our presentation of this WEEU Holiday Festival of Community Sound, sponsored by Reading Musical Foundation, it's my pleasure to present our next guitarist. He's a lifelong resident of Reading and fluent in all styles of guitar, including classical, ragtime, pop, and rock. He's also been responsible for teaching scores of students the various styles of guitar that he's proficient in. His album, A Rose for Christmas, is one of the most relaxing and beautiful holiday recordings for guitar available anywhere. Please enjoy his playing now, Berks County's own Mr. Rod Hill.
Next, we're going to be listening to some more recordings by David Cullen. This one is called What Strangers Are These? However, in this recording, he's joined by his colleague Will Ackermann, the founder of Windham Hill Records, a man who performed here during our Guitar-O-Rama several years ago during our Berks Country Fest in the summertime. Will and David won their Grammy Awards for the work that they did together on Windham Hill and that label, so it's appropriate that they also released a compact disc, a recording session of holiday music. So again, What Strangers Are These? By David Cullen, Berks County's own, and Will Ackermann from the Vermont area. And after this, we'll hear from the Berks Youth Chorus.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas to you. You're listening to WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound. I'm Dave Klein, inviting you to listen throughout the program as your family, friends, neighbors, loved ones, perhaps even co-workers raise their voice in song or tell us stories and help to relive happy memories as we make new ones here with our radio family, which of course includes you. The show is brought to you virtually commercial-free for its entire length, except for two messages per hour from the Reading Musical Foundation. Now, the Reading Musical Foundation is a 501c3 nonprofit entity which does great work by helping to fund concert promoters who present fabulous concerts in our community, which, of course, enriches all of our lives. And the Reading Musical Foundation also offers scholarship money for students who wish to enhance their abilities on their instrument through lessons or master classes. And in some cases, the Reading Musical Foundation even provides funding for instrument upgrades. The Reading Musical Foundation also has a fantastic program called Operation Replay. So basically, you take your instrument, your used instrument that's just sitting around gathering dust, no pianos, please, to the Reading Musical Foundation's office in the Goggle Works. And when you go there, they will give you a receipt for the instrument based on the value that you say it is and that they agree to. And so you get a benefit that way for tax purposes, but you also have the bigger benefit of knowing deep down, way inside of your being, in your heart, that you've given the gift of music to some young person who cannot afford a musical instrument and who may change the world, even if only in a small way, through the power of music. That's just a bit of what the Reading Musical Foundation represents in our community. So when you listen to this show, think the joy of music and think about the entity that helps us spread that joy, especially at this time of year. And that's the Reading Musical Foundation, again, located in their office on the fifth floor of the Goggle Works building in downtown Reading.
Greetings of the season to you. This is Jack Holcomb. Nature has inspired many things in art, music, and beyond, and our holiday tree decorating traditions are no exception. During this holiday, many folks decorate a fanciful tree with all kinds of ornaments, including various things representing nature. But have you ever wondered about the meanings, traditions, and folklore behind some of these ornaments? For example, pigs have long been considered lucky animals. The term Dickbauch, meaning fat stomach, is still popularly used in Germany on Christmas Eve. According to tradition, those who do not eat well on Christmas Eve will be haunted by demons at night. So, a dinner of roasted pork on Christmas Eve is thought to fatten everyone up and prevent any evil, as well as serve as an omen for a prosperous upcoming year.
Next up on our WEEU Holiday Festival of Sound, we're going to enjoy the Church Bell Choir from the Trinity Lutheran Church of southwestern Berks in Robesonia.
Thank you. Hi, this is WEEU's Paul Roberts, and that was Robesonia's Trinity Lutheran Church Handbell Choir, and this is WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound. To all of you from all of us, Merry Christmas!
Christmas stockings are hung near the chimney on Christmas Eve for Santa Claus to fill it with goodies for the children. Well, it's an empty sock or a bag that is given in the shape of a sock. The children in the United States and some other countries have been following this tradition of hanging a Christmas stocking, believing that Father Christmas, or Santa, will fill it with sweets and gifts for them. The items that are believed to be stuffed in the Christmas stocking by Santa Claus himself are known as stocking stuffers. The tradition of the Christmas stockings began by a story told since ancient time about a kind nobleman who had three daughters. The wife of the nobleman expired, and the daughters and their father were left in a state of sorrow. The daughters had to do all the work in the house, and when the daughters became young and eligible for marriage, the poor father could not afford to give them the huge dowries to their husbands. Now, one evening, the daughters, after washing their stockings, hung them near the fireplace to be dried. Santa Claus, being moved by the plight of the daughters, came in and put in three bags of gold, one in each of the stockings hanging by the chimney. The next morning, the family noticed the gold bags, and the nobleman had enough for his daughters' marriages. The daughters got married, and they lived happily ever after, and since then, children have been hanging Christmas stockings. Now, Christmas stockings are supposed to be given gifts by Santa Claus. The other gifts are wrapped in present papers and placed near the Christmas tree. It's believed that a child who misbehaves during the year will not get a gift in the Christmas stocking. That's what they say. The Christmas stockings are traditionally hung on the fireplace, but as most of the modern homes do not have fireplaces, any location suitable for hanging the Christmas stockings. In many traditions, the Christmas stockings to be stuffed by a gift that will stimulate the five sensory organs. A gift given by Santa Claus would be something to eat, maybe a thing that makes a sound and gives a pleasant view to the eyes, or a gift which has a lovely fragrance. In the present modern culture, there are special Christmas stockings available in the market, and some families, though, still design unique stockings for themselves, for each family member. And maybe they'll get some gold in it on Christmas morning.
Next up on our WEEU Holiday Festival of Sound, we're going to feature members of the Fleetwood Area High School from their Music for the Holidays compact disc. This cut is entitled Sing We Now of Christmas.
Christmas, no one sing to death.
Hello, this is Matt Gorney, and you're listening to WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound, a nostalgic musical and narrative celebration of the season featuring the talent of your friends, co-workers, neighbors, and family in and around our community. The recordings you'll enjoy during this broadcast have been made right here in our own community at local concert halls, schools, theaters, and right here in WEEU Studios at 34 North 4th Street in Reading, Pennsylvania. WEEU's Holiday Festival of Sound is brought to you by the Reading Musical Foundation, and we'll be right back with our show after this word from the RMF.
Can a musical instrument change the life of a child? The Reading Musical Foundation knows it can. Musicianship teaches children important life skills like teamwork, determination, discipline, self-esteem, and precision. Research studies confirm the enhancement of academic and social performance when children participate in their school's instrument or choral program. Music matters. Help to make a difference in your community by supporting the work of the Reading Musical Foundation.